Let's check on the situation at major Metro Manila cemeteries as the All Souls Day observance nears its end. Visitors who spend their night at the Manila Memorial Park in Parañaque are starting to pack up and go home. Park management says 150,000 people were at the cemetery last night, and that number has since gone down to 16,000 this morning. Traffic on roads near the Memorial Park, though, is still heavy. The park will close at 6 p.m. this evening, and people will no longer be allowed to stay overnight. The foot traffic at the Manila North Cemetery also noticeably lower. For the latest data, there were 86,000 visitors at the park today. Despite this, police are still deployed, with some officers patrolling on bicycles. We're also seeing fewer people at the Heroes Cemetery in Taguig. Only about 3,200 visitors went there this morning. Security measures, however, remain in place, such as the confiscation of deadly weapons and flammable materials and the prohibition of noise-making activities. Officials say there are fewer visitors this year, possibly due to the extended holiday, which enticed people to travel or go back to their provinces. Toll rates are going up at the South Luzon Expressway beginning Friday. Jackie Manabat has the details.
The Toll Regulatory Board has approved adjustment of toll fees for the South Luzon Expressway, or SLEX, with the implementation set to begin tomorrow, November 3. This comes after the CRB authorized the collection of provisional toll rate adjustments for SLEX following petitions for approval of periodic toll rate adjustments. That's for 2012 and 2014. Starting tomorrow, November 3, motorists traveling from Alabang to Calamba will see an additional charge of 10 pesos for Class 1 vehicles, 20 pesos for Class 2 vehicles, and 30 pesos for Class 3 vehicles. Meanwhile, those traveling from Calamba to Santo Tomas, Batangas will face an additional fee of 4 pesos, 6 pesos, and 8 pesos for Class 1, Class 2, and Class 3 vehicles, respectively. And to address concerns about the impact of the toll rate adjustments on the general welfare and existing inflationary situation, the PRB said that it has directed that the increase be implemented in two tranches. The first tranche will take effect this year, that's tomorrow, and with the second tranche is scheduled for the following year. Now, this marks the first periodic toll rate adjustment for SLEX since 2011.
News here at home, the Angat Hydroelectric Power Plant will be on total shutdown for 2 months for repair and rehabilitation. Authorities say the maintenance shutdown from November 6 to January 6, 2024 is needed to prolong the plant's lifespan to ensure a stable water supply for domestic consumption and irrigation. Since the dam is near its normal high water level, utility providers Maynilad and Manila Water assured their customers that water supply should be stable throughout the shutdown period. Metro Manila's water regulator echoing that assurance. The MWSS says supply will continue to flow through the low-level outlet and the spillway to meet the needs in the capital region. Filipinos are taking full advantage of the long Undas break to travel to their respective provinces or just enjoy the holidays away from home. According to the Manila International Airport Authority, over 732,000 Filipinos have been processed at Binaia terminals in the first 6 days of Undas. Airport authorities expected to hit their projected goal of serving 1.2 million passengers during the 10-day break. The MIAA also reporting that daily flights surpassed 800 on November 1st, with an 88% on-time performance.
A U.S.-based company betting big on Philippine venture firm Talino Venture Studios, Chemonix International, has invested around $5 million into Talino with the aim of bridging the financial inclusion gap in the country and other emerging markets worldwide. Talino CEO Winston Damarillo says the partnership with Chemonix could benefit up to 50 million unbanked Filipinos. Talino has so far collaborated with fintech firms such as Buy and Pay, Ascenso, and Saffron. For numbers that matter, this All Souls Day, something on life and even death, Data from the Philippine Statistics Authority show registered deaths from the January to April period were down by 23% from last year's. This is equal to 174,000 deaths against the 226,000 in 2022. Now, during that period, registered births was also down at over 320,000, lower by 25% than last year's figures. The PSA says the Southern Tagalog region had the highest number of both deaths and births among all regions in the Philippines.